Get out of here. Stupid geese. Go on!
Sorry, Ma. At least they spared you this time. Yeah, I know. You're right. You're always right. They're all God's creatures, Davy. Where else are they gonna go? Tear down all the trees, their habitats, their usual haunts. Put up more malls we don't need. These and golf courses, the only green spaces left for them to go. And you know they'll never pave over a golf course. Where'd your thing go? That flag thingy I brought you last time. You know, I told the office this keeps happening. Well, you leave tributes at your own discretion. We can't be held responsible for lost or stolen. You wonder why I left this church? They're the first ones with their hand out, but boy, the minute you need something. I don't know how you stayed. That politics tearing apart the choir. Well, now they're stuck with you. A very Gandhian strategy of you there, Ma. Now they have to deal with your body. Yep, just like they had to deal with his. Millions of people marching for peace, and one little idiot doesn't get the message. That's just like Oswald. That's what I wanted to tell you. I forgot the last time. You know how all those experts could never figure out how he could have hit Kennedy from that height and distance? Well, he would have had to have been an expert marksman of all expert marksmen. All those years. The whole cottage industry springing up around November 11th, 1963. All these experts, all these theories, and all of them overlooking the simplest explanation. He wasn't aiming for Kennedy. Governor Connally in the front seat, he was Oswald's target. Ain't that some stuff? The forensics now all support it. The shots coming from the depository. The only reason Kennedy reeled back was because the muscles in his back spasmed. They're the strongest muscles in the body, so... But yeah, you know, Connally was the target, not JFK. Oswald was already a suspect for killing that cop earlier in the day, which is why the FBI was already searching his house. The first agent there found his diary, and there was a hidden, handwritten kill list. Richard Nixon was on it. For some reason. The FBI agent that had been harassing Oswald's wife about her citizenship, since she was a Russian national, some hawk in the Defense Department, and at the top of the list, complete with crudely drawn bloody daggers, Governor Connally. Apparently, when Oswald was living in Russia, he was having a tough time moving back to the States. He wrote an impassioned plea to Connally, thinking a fellow Texan would help him out. Instead, he gets a form letter. And there's your motive for taking a life. Sure, Oswald's wife had testified under oath, twice, that Connally was the intended target, but nobody cared. The president had been assassinated. Easier to imagine a grand scheme. Something had to be at play to take such a beloved man. There had to have been a reason. And even a bad reason is more palpable than dumb, spiraling chance. Now, the thing is, when the diary was officially entered into evidence, that page with the kill list was ripped out. That was the government conspiracy. Hoover saw the FBI agent's name on that list, and he didn't want his organization dragged through the mud. Likewise, LBJ has a personal friend in Connally, and he didn't want the governor to become an object of scorn. Remember, November 11th, 1963, the day Oswald missed. I thought you'd want to know. That was your generation. That was your time. He was your president. You deserve to know. Don't forget your dying king, right? Yeah, well, all right. Go complain to the office now, if they're not closed. Oh. If it's not one thing, maybe tonight I'll swing by the store and pick up another one of those flag thingies for you. Maybe for Jack, too.